Welcome viewers to Software Demy. Our course content today about Primavera P6. Our topic today is activity types. I have already explained you how to create activity, and in that topic I already defined activity 6 types. So now I will practically show you how to apply these types in schedule and where we need these types and how these types implement on schedule and how these activities affect after implementation. So in the bottom I have opened Primavera P6. I open my villa construction project. Here I open my villa construction project. So my friends and my viewers, here I have seen start, finish, original, duration, activity name and activity ID. Here I add a new column, and that one should be calendar. I need calendar for this one. This is very important. Calendar, I will go for calendar CA. L C A L. Here in the general you can find it, calendar. I will push it to last, apply OK. Here it's clear. So ranger's name calendar is assigned already. So I will continue it. So here in the general tab you can see activity types. Here you can see general, in general, activity types, task dependent. This task dependent activity is the general activity based on resources. Everybody knows it's applied on successor and predecessors, and may be affected by resources and calculated general by calendar. So it's generally used, this activity generally used mostly, relationship assigned to this activity, and this is mostly run on critical path. So we will not discuss about task dependent, it's general, people use this one. So we can also discuss project start. Here you can see start date only assigned, project start, it means start milestone, and the last one, project completion, it's a finish milestone. I created finish milestone. See here, the date removed and the finish milestone comes. And two milestone I have signed. I show you how to remove the dates of finish, start, and three. Our three activity types is done. Finish milestone and the start milestone and the task dependent. I will discuss you further level of effort, resource dependent, and WBS. So task dependent are activities which are dependent on predecessor and successors. Directly duration is applied on it, and its general activity depend on task we have assigned. The start milestone is the only milestone or activity which have only start date, and the finish milestone is an activity which have only finish date. So these are three types I have explained you. Now I will move for resource dependent. So resource dependent, I have already told you the definition of resource dependent. So if a machine can work 5 days in a day and 2 days off, so it will be worked only for 5 days. For example, there is an excavation work, and we can do this excavation work. This is a 15 days activity. So but we, the excavator we use or machine we use is using other calendar. So I will go for there. I will change calendar from here. Our calendar should be 5 day week work, means rather we work 6 days and we week, we will work 5 days. So when I applied this activity, this calendar, and when I change the activity into resource dependent, you can see the bar changes, and here I assign new bars. When I go there and I assign new bars for restore dependent and change the preview, and I go for here and I change, make a filter for that one. So you can see resource dependent modify, I have filtered by resource dependent, I removed from normal. So here you can see resource dependent, this activity come into 12 days duration. When I schedule it, it go to for 12 days. When I change the calendar, it activity directly, because it's resource dependent and I change the calendar, and so resource are dependent on it, and you can see the bar is changed. So I will show you something more. The other activity type is WBS summary. So if I need excavation and trimming and leveling of trenches summary, I can add an activity here, insert, and I will give the name or number to activity summary of excavation. In the project we can add anywhere summary of any activity we can calculate, because it's an activity WBS. We can assign the activity type WBS summary, and when we sort it and here you can see this activity is added. So when I schedule it, you can see here the duration is 5 days. See it clearly. When I schedule it, it goes automatically calculate 22 days of these activities. Excavation, trimming and termite. All these activities will be done in 22 days up to 12 March. You can see 12 March is our maximum date, so that's why it decided to 12 March, and 20 February is our least date, that's why it added this date. This activity can be added in every WBS, it will be change behavior. In every WBS its behavior will be changed. We can change calendars from here, it will be changed calendars as you write, and it will be count exactly the days which is calculated from the first day to last day. So I will control Z here, and now I will add a level of effort activity, my last activity. I will add here level of effort, insert. I will add insert. Here is mostly our project management activities are level of effort. Here I add activity for level of effort. I assign it level of effort. Here I go for relationship. My predecessor is project start, and my successor is issuance of drawing. I assign finish to finish, and here you can see I have assigned both relationship. So when I schedule it, you can see it's automatically calculate the duration of 31st January to 19. It's automatically will be calculated until your project duration is completed. It will be throughout. When you don't know about the what is the duration of your activity, you assign level of effort, so it automatically calculate the duration of your activity as you pre-know your activity duration. So here I can change my duration 5 days. If I change my duration after I got my BOQ, when I change my duration 5 days, and when I change my duration to 8 days, here and I change my duration to 9 days, and when I schedule it, you can see it's changing 30 days. Here, this is level of effort. You can see it clearly. I have show you in the bars. It's filtered by level of effort, resource dependent, I told you, WBS summary. So my viewers, I have told you all the types of activities, how and where we applied. Level of effort is applied on project management activities up to plans where you don't know about the duration. Actually, predecessor and successor are assigned, and WBS is used, activity summary is where you need the summary of your WBS, and the resource dependent activities are those where the calendar is changed or your activity is based on resources, and you can assign the resource activity or resource dependent activity there. These are three types which are different, we don't mostly use. So please like, comment, share, and subscribe my channel, and press the bell icon for latest upcoming notification. See you in next video.